纽西兰最高法院裁定现行18岁才能投票不符合纽国的权利法案，因为法案赋予公民在年满16岁有不受年龄歧视的权利。这项裁定使得国会不得不讨论要将投票门槛下修到16岁，不过却引发不少争论，毕竟16岁高中还没毕业。
We do not support lowering the voting age to 16. The reason because of that is I want to seeMore civics education introduced in our schools. That is so important, you know, to educate and to enable our young people to understand, you know, the operations of government, local government, councils, and central government, and how they work in our society.
Fisher 王2019年以19岁之资参选，当选成为纽西兰罗托鲁市最年轻的议员。对于国会讨论下修投票年龄，他认为不太妥当。
You know, public issues all have their pros and cons. And what's your opposition in the community in New Zealand on this topic? Is there a lot of, you know, requirement or lack of discussion in the community?
There is a big discussion in the community, and I think particularly with young people in the society. I think when you turn 18, yeah, like I said before, there's that you are an adult now. You've left high school, moved on to do whatever you want to do. But I also understand in New Zealand, you know, there's a lot of 16 to 17 year olds that also work and also pay taxes, you know, but.I really still believe that, you know, we do need to introduce and push for that civics education. I think that is absolutely really important.
反观台湾18岁公民权修宪公投没有通过，国内主要政党都表态力挺，但公投结果不如预期，显示国人对此议题看法保留。
台湾在过去，我们在90年代的时候就有人提出这个倡议，但是有许多人担心会不会把这个选举权，也就是所谓的投票权降到18岁的时候，会让这个政治进入到校园，那导致这个学术不中立，校园不中立，或者是说政治进入到了这个学校里面这样的关系啊。每一个国家在进行这个选举投票年龄的这个限制或者是说规定的时候，不见得是在宪法层次，很多国家就是在公职选举法里面来做规定，但是我国是因为在宪法，所以我们有一个修宪过程。
And I would say this to, you know, young people in Taiwan as well. And it was really disappointing to see that, you know, that vote did not pass.I really hope that it would, because, you know, to bring the voting age down to 18, I think that is a great thing to do. Don't lose hope. You know, there's so many things that young people are able to achieve.
事实上，民法通过成年从20岁下修至18岁，预计2023年正式实施，但却没有投票资格，使外界产生权责不相符的感受。想要下修投票与参政法定年龄层，要考量的不仅是社会共识，影响因素也包括修法门槛。参考国外经验，反思台湾18岁公民权下一步该如何继续走下去。中央社记者吴声宏特别报道。